What's up everyone? In this video, I'm going to show how you can freeze any Excel row, column, or both so that when you scroll or move your arrow keys in any directions, they stay in place. I have this very large Excel file with 17 columns and over 210,000 rows of data. The header info can be found in the first row of the table. If I go all the way down with Control Down, we can see that the header is no longer visible now. Well, if I wanted to make it visible when I go all the way down, I can go back to the first row in cell A1, go to the View tab, and then go to Freeze Panes, and then select Freeze Top Row, which will keep the top row visible while scrolling through the rest of the worksheet. Now, if I do Control Down again, we can see that the header information is available, along with the rest of the data that can fit in our screen. Now, if I want to do unfreeze the top row, then I can go back to Freeze Panes, and select Unfreeze Panes, click on it, and if I just scroll all the way up, we can see that the top row is no longer frozen, so we don't see it anymore. What if I want you to freeze the first column only? That way, when I scroll left or right, the column stays in place. Well, I can go back to Freeze Panes once again, and just select Freeze First Column, which is pretty self-explanatory. That way, when I scroll to the right, column A stays in place, and when I scroll to the left, column A still stays in place. The last thing I'm going to show you is how you can freeze both columns and rows so that you can freeze your cells in any location. I'm going to unfreeze the first column. Let's say that you wanted to freeze everything before column C, which I'll highlight in yellow, and everything above row 5, which I'll highlight in orange. Well, what we want to do is that we want to select the cell at the intersection point between column C and row 5, which is cell C5, go back to the View tab, and then select Freeze Panes again. And we want to select the Freeze Panes option here, which will keep the rows and columns visible while the rest of the worksheet can scroll based on the current selection. Select this. Now, if I scroll to the right, we can see that the columns A and B are in place. If I scroll down, we can see that rows 1 through 4 are in place as well. So this is a way to freeze both columns and rows in place. So that's pretty much an overview of how you can freeze any rows or columns in Excel. If you found this video to be helpful, then please like and comment down below what else you'd want to see. And if you haven't already, subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram and LinkedIn to get notified of when I upload a video again. Until then, I'll see you guys again next time.